Oh, hey guys, how's it going? Miss Kanan, as you might remember yesterday, has been having quite a time, and she's currently MIA, but that's alright. She deserves time to herself just as much as anybody else does. I'm guessing she came home from work and took a nap, and now she's, recovering, and believe you me, when you burn the candle at both ends, you know, sometimes it takes its toll. So, I've left the Skype line open, so if she manages to, awake before showtime is over, we'll get her in no problem. So, in the meantime, when we last left our heroes, me, if that counts, I was in the process of rebuilding Sheogorath's staff, and, oh hey Chuckzy, oh hey Wordman, oh hi Eraser, wise from your grave, hello Yoshimitsu. Well, 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 what's going on guys? What is going on the Monday Night Raw tonight? See everybody like, she won't be asleep? Because I haven't heard from her. And I just found out that Lady's going to a Metallica concert on Thursday, which is awesome. Good for her. Red Punk, Panty Capable. Uh-oh, editing anger. Showering and fooding, okay. Well, Wordman, I assumed it was because she had decided to take a nap and then overstayed, which tends to happen. You know, she's been working out a lot lately, so I wouldn't hold that against her in the slightest. But according to Domino, she is showering and fooding. Eraser, I had also would have thought it might have had something to do with fireworks and, alcohol consumption, but, it appears that neither is the case. So, that being said, on with the program! And now I'm over encumbered. How about that? I'm waiting around for so long. Alright, so what was I doing? Building a staff and something else happened. Oh yeah, okay. We'll go inside. Thank you, Red Punk, I appreciate that. You're getting an uploading error. Oh no! Uploading error of what? What is the error? Light vision engaged. You gonna shoot magic at me? Good adventures always go left. Oh, it's one of those, huh? It doesn't matter which way you go, you always end up in the same place. Whoa. What are you? Hitpocket Apostle. You don't have a name, so I'm assuming you're a hostile. Or not. I have no greeting. What is going on with the top of the screen? What just happened? What is happening?
Certainly.
Okay, so you have dialogue. Okay.
See you later.
Okay, that was interesting.
I used to think you were a hero.
I don't know what that was, but now it's working. Yeah, DAP programming. Good job. When you have a game this complicated, bugs are bound to happen. Like a dancing sword, as we saw last week.
Hundreds of years ago, this very building once served as a temple in Cyrodiil that sought to cure
the mad.
It was in this temple that Emperor Pelagius was taken during his madness.
Where they take him to?
After his death in these very halls, The temple
oh,
was
no,
destroyed.
Not that.
We stole the stones from Cyrodiil and reassembled the temple here, in the Shivering Isles.
Brick by brick. Wordman, what are you talking about? Exploit is having a problem? Oh, way to go. Way to go, Don.
I hear the shield of the Crusader's been found.
That Cyrodiil dialogue. Man, that's... Oh, that bar? That wasn't me. That was the game. Congratulations, Red Punk. I know what it's like. There's the swing set glitch in Sleeping Dogs, except you don't need a swing set. Oh my.
We seek the light with an open eye and an open heart. We carve the flesh away, seeking the light within. The light reveals all secrets and knows all thoughts. None can hide from it, and it shines in all places. Forsake the flesh, and you shall know the light.
You know, Wes Johnson talks about a lot of the creepy lines that he says is loose in LaChance. He's never brought up that one before. I'll have to ask him about that at MAGFest next year.
Goodbye.
That is... I'd like to see him do that when he's announcing the capitals. It's like, strip away the flesh, seek the truth, rock the red! Soda machine. You clay. Potion of dispel. Strong potion of sorcery. Show you sorcery. Well, at least I can run around here. I don't believe I'm in hostile territory.
Oh, go.
Have no fear, brother. It is only me.
Ah, I see.
How many
well,
ice cream
friend.
Bars can someone eat in
With
one
all
city?
The new
what?
Recruits, it is hard to be certain.
Oh yeah, Red Punk. Blackboard woes go
Bye.
Down on me.
What? I hear
that
the
sounded very
of the Crusader's
wrong.
Been found.
Blackboard would never work whenever I needed to submit something, and I would always have to email my professor saying, "Hey, Blackboard Bye. Decided to go ahead and not work at the most inopportune of times." Why are you hostile? What is this? So I'm just gonna keep walking. Gold. Are they supposed to be hostile or not? I don't understand. Well, it's not red. Da 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 da. Delicious. Where's that basket? I don't need it. Handy capable? What are you talking about? Did you get like an upload error from like YouTube or something? Oh, and speaking of YouTube, how about that guy that called out Jared the other night? I've been having a little feud with him.
I
oh,
used
stop
to think
it.
You were. Goodbye.
Someone pitched this Greg ice bar. Ice cream bar eating challenge? Holy balls. I remember when they did the donut eating challenge at Iron Man 08. It was Jose and Mike the Birdman Dodd. That was nuts. I'm gonna get up there.
Goodbye.
Get up there. There we go. No. See. White people can jump, we just need extra magic. Cause you gotta remember I'm playing as the most tragically white elf chick ever. No! Oh well. Yeah, Birdman does have diabetes. Among other complications because of his weight. I'm pretty sure 90% of that would fade away if he sought a diet. He has made significant progress, though. Every summer, I always see another tweet about him being able to bust out a pair of an outfit that he swore he'd never be able to wear again, so that's cool. Now that I'm one to talk, I'm in the midst of a diet struggling to get back down here. Yeah, actually, you know what, guys? Let me go ahead and find the name of this guy. If you want to go and leave and be polite, we don't need to incriminate ourselves against anything. Here we go. It's Samuel Ta GTA. So SamuelTeHGTA. Samuel Ta GTA, all one word. He called out Jared about a tweet saying people that are denying that YouTubers are the next celebrity status need to get their priorities in check. This guy is sorely mistaken.
You do not belong here. Quickly, put on a robe before the others see you. They will kill you on sight. Please, I mean you no violence. Perhaps you can help me.
Apostles' robes. Yeah, Samuel to GTA. He's a bit of a jerk. Red Punk, kill him with kindness. G1s are not going to go ahead and storm this guy's channel and say slanderous things. Just go ahead and watch the video and note all the gigantic flaws in his argument. And let him know why he's wrong. Because I gotta understand that, you know I'm small potatoes. He doesn't seem to think he is. Even on his best channel, which has 6 million views, Jared's got something to the tune of 11 million? And he's only been around as half as long, but you gotta remember, his Slender video, 4.3 million views. In one video, Jared has done two-thirds as much work as that guy has done in his 5-year history. Yeah, you saw that thing too, Red Punk. 6 million views, bro!
Good, good. Your face is known to me. One so famous as you cannot expect to walk around the aisles unrecognized, can you?
You are the Duchess, name of the video, yes. Handy Cable was called, I
and
told Sheogorath you so.
And Sheogorath has sent you to find Sirta, has he not? He finally seeks to kill her. Still, for whatever reason you are here, you mean Sirta ill, yes? Don't bother refuting me, I know the truth.
Oh yeah, yes, the new Guilty Gear game that's coming
but
out. How's everybody liking that?
There are those of us here who want her gone as well, yes. Those of us who think that maybe we could lead better than she does. So, if you will help me, I will help you. Sirta will die, and you will not need to lift a finger. Then you can take one.
Yeah, it's funny that you mentioned that, Don, because I know they play at BlazBlue. They played that at Evo 1 year, but I don't know if they still do or not.
I require
weapons
for myself and for the apostles that will help me do the deed. But Sirta already is suspicious of me. She has forbidden me and those who support me from carrying weapons.
Yeah, Clay Kanan's kind of MIA at the moment. She's fooding and showering and all that fun stuff, so hopefully she'll show up before showtime is over. Oh, she just tweeted a picture of fireworks. It's a time to herself. That's important. Yep, that's the video, Woody. That's him, all right. Hold on, let me send Cannon a message. Oh, he is definitely a smug fellow. And you know what the thing is that he says that YouTube is such an unstable economy to do business in, and he said he's doing it because he's a journalist. There's something wrong with the way he seems to be thinking about things. And he especially goes on and says, you know, he defends Nintendo's decision, which, remember, they do have the legal right to go ahead and start taking the ad revenue from YouTube channels that are using their content. But he says that, you know, that everybody should do that and follow suit. Well, the thing is, he doesn't point out that he has a separate YouTube channel that is strictly for game reviews and stuff, which means that he's going to be directly affected by that. So the way I like to equate this Samuel fella is kind of like Bill O'Reilly, who intentionally goes around and stirs up the hornet's nest to go ahead and get people to watch his channel, because I'm almost willing to bet Raph dollars that that channel that he posted that video on is monetized, creating controversy for the sake of creating controversy, and then reaping in the rewards as a benefit of it. So screw him. Go ahead and downvote his video and leave a polite and intelligently worded comment about why he's wrong. All right. Oh yeah, and skip the pre-roll ad so he doesn't get credit for it either.
Very clever, Your Grace. Bring to me three apostle daggers. Sirta must be slain with the weapons of the light if I am to take her place. No other weapons. But you must be discreet. Do not remove the robes, or you will be attacked. Even I will have
Oh,
to
I would like
kill
to see you
you,
try, buddy.
so I do not draw more suspicion to myself. And be cautious of killing my allies. I cannot forgive that crime. You will know them, as they are also forbidden to carry daggers. Will you help me bring the apostles
He
to the
doesn't even
light
lift.
and help yourself?
Don, you're not too far off because that's quickly where his conversation with me is going. I wouldn't be surprised if he's resorted to name calling on the next exchange. Oh, really? Where are you in Chrono Trigger right now?
Too long, Sirta has led us here. Always against Sheogorath,
Because you made
always.
it to the
We
end
are
of time.
tired of her vendetta.
How far have you gotten
Sirta
since
brought
then?
us here with promises to show us the light, but always is about Sheogorath, is about revenge. Sirta lied, but when she is done, I will lead the acolytes to the light. In truth, Sirta is weak. She needs all the able bodies she can get. This is why you
Oh,
were able
wow.
to walk in here
Good
wearing
progress,
our
Woody.
robes
Enjoy
and
that game
not be
like a
harmed.
finely prepared steak
Always
dinner.
she wants to strike at Sheogorath. She needs people, and she leads them here with lies.
Lies.
Do not be foolish. We can both get what we want. Come to me when you have made a
Lady, if you
decision.
want to jump on the Skype machine, you're more than welcome to. Kanan is out fireworking, fooding, and showering. So, she'll be here when she gets here. If you has headset, you can hop on if you want.
A lot of history has this place. It was I who led the apostles to steal the stones from
Robo is
Cyrodiil
amazing.
when
Always
the
have him in your party if
original
you can.
temple was destroyed. We rebuilt it here, as it was when it hosted its most
Oh,
famous guest.
sadness.
Sometimes at night, I can still hear Emperor
Wow,
Palladius
Don, that's not
screaming.
stalkerish at all. And maybe I forgot, dude. Domino. Sorry, not Don. That is, jeez, that is creeptastic that you even saw that.
Sirta promised to bring us to the light. It is a way, a promise of a better future, free from the
Good listener.
shackles of Sheogorath.
Sure thing,
The
buddy.
light is knowledge, she says. Forsake all ignorance and morality in favor of the light, she
Tap your
teaches.
shoes. Click your heel three times. There's no headset like Astra. There's no headset like Astra. Dreams of revenge against
Shagora. She is a liar.
Ooh, shower taco.
In our lives. Soon, we will seek the light without her.
Show you the light without her. Well then, okay.
See you later.
Alligator. Well, I'm invisible, so it really doesn't matter. So. Okay. Let's go talk to Sirta, because for some reason I got the feeling that that guy's just trying to stage a coup for his own ends. And that said, I should probably... No offense, Clay. okay. Let's see if we can't find Sirta, because that's, Greg... Skelly and Zoa? What? Yeah, word man, he doesn't even know what he's talking about. And I've never seen a video on YouTube with these creepypasta stuff that he's talking about, so... Maybe that is a fad that died a while ago, but man, I've never seen anybody that I know as a content producer doing those. What is in this display case? Ooh, gold pieces. There we go. Pelvis of okay, that's staying in there. These guys and their scavenging of body parts. Honestly. Creepypasta still fresh. I don't know, it seems like it's gotten stale to me. Because it's pasta, get it? Ah! Oh! Okay, I gotcha, Woody. Misunderstood. Why, Jordan? Some people just like to watch the world burn, that's why. Wizard of Oz jokes. What? Oh, that's Sirta? Luminary Kaz? Kazurai? Master Miller? Alright, talk to me.
I will cast you into the darkness! She was innocent.
Yeah, and so were you, apparently. Am I unable to talk? Wait a minute. Maybe it's I gotta wear that stupid robe after all. No, you know what? Let's say it. Because this seems like a bad idea. All around. Oh, I'm not saying creepypasta like the website itself is, like, done and over with. I'm talking about people live reading them over gameplay footage. I've never seen any of the content producers that I follow do that. That's what I'm talking about, is it being foreign to me.
I will cast you into the
well, that
darkness.
Didn't work. I just got a late tweet from the Woody. Ah! See? See? New camera. Pictures on phone actually show up properly. Skelly. That is the creepiest clown I've ever seen in my life. What is... I'm 12 and what is this? Okay, this guy kind of looks like he belongs in Shivering Isles, just based on the armor and all that stuff. Raid mode, yeah. Whoops. Like, I imagine there's gotta be, That's only Zophie talking off caps. Right. Okay, I can't seem to talk to them. Let's see what's in here. Because I talked to that one guy. Whoa, you can see me? Ow. Life detect.
Well, whatever it was, it's gone now.
Don't come at me, man. I can take you out before you can find me. I don't know what we're talking about. Or what we're yelling about. Okay, so... I don't know why this isn't working. Bug. Oh, I'm supposed to... Right, supposed to get the eyes of Sarah. I thought it was supposed to be like a symbolic thing where, like, you know, I pluck them out or something like that, like Kill Bill, but nope, gotta kill her. Who puts stuff up here on the rafters? Honestly, and there's stone rafters, too. You gotta have, like, telekinesis magic. Which I do have. Well, you know what? No harm in, I don't know what we're yelling about! Hold on. Woody just sent me another one. Woody says he ain't kidding. Enough, the text is coming through on that. No focus. Well, Zoa says, "Be well, I can fight alongside you again!" All caps. You guys are waking up all the neighbors. So where do I get these daggers, or should I just do it myself? You know what, I saved. Let's do it ourselves. Like a boss. And for the record, if you please spell it B-O-S-S. If I catch anyone spelling it B-A-U-S. No, all of my no. Okay, so, anyways. Hey, Sirena. That wasn't terribly difficult. I killed Sirena. Taking her eye will be a simple matter now. Lightning, eh. That'd be great if I was a, superior... That's lovely. It's kind of like that scene in Minority Report. Big Bass? The Boogie Bass? No, B-A-W-S is equally bad. Oh my gosh. Zap! What's happening? How's it going, everybody? Red Punk, do I believe in S.H.I.E.L.D.? Not the NVIDIA S.H.I.E.L.D., nope. Alright, back to the hollow we go. And since we're saved, and if things don't work out, we go back to our Khajiit buddy. Buddy in air quotes. find out what happens here. Shoe fly, don't bother me. Wonder what your beef is.
Sirta has fallen into darkness. Rakiran will lead the apostles to the light.
You sent me something. Well, now that she's dead, you seem to be well and happy to take care of it all by yourself. Clay, what is this? It's my deagle! My deagle! Okay, so he seems to be all content. Kick him in the shins. That'd be great if there was such a move like that. For hand-to-hand combat, just go around kicking people in the shins. And stop everybody. I swear to God, getting kicked in the shins is the worst. Give a little boot-boot, it's okay. Run up the top of the stairs, that's impossibly fast. Oh no, Red Punk, I have a feeling I'm gonna regret this. Yep, I am, bye-bye. Stuff of my nightmares. Gross. Because you know that's exactly what I want to spend my time looking at. Okay, so. It's broad daylight. What is that blue mark on the map for again? Where is it? Oh, it's that thing again. Right. Square. Oh yeah, back to that place again. Right. Yeah, Darkstalkers is a pretty rad game, except for that stage. Everything else is cool, just not that stage. Screw that. F that noise. It's sideways. And I come to a dramatic halt when I run out of magic to lighten the load, as it were. You know, wouldn't that be something if you got over-encumbered when you were underwater and you didn't have enough magic to lighten the load again? And you're on fire. Actually, there was a Mage's Guild quest where you're supposed to get this ring from the bottom of a well, and it's a ring of encumbrance, and it's like, if you do it at the level that you're supposed to do it, it's like 150 pounds the instant you put the ring on. So the person that tried to like get it last time drowned, because you know, the guy was setting them up to lose. But I was all tanked out because I was doing nothing but like side quests and like just wandering around the countryside and doing stuff. That I was able to walk out of the well with the ring in my possession. Thought that was pretty funny. Alright, buddy, bye bye. Tweet as you exit. Wait, what? Oh, the train stage? Oh, yeah, the train that has a mouth on it. That was always a little special. Whoops, I'm going completely the wrong direction now. Oh, look at that guy, he's a big one. Oh, yeah. Give me my arrow back. Oh, he's got the seizures. He's got the sugars. The diabetes. Climb that hill. There we go. Get up there. Excellent. Party body. Is it gonna be like Party Boy? Are we gonna have to play the Party Boy music? Looks like I've been here before. Yep, sure have. if John Cena was shot in both knees, he would still put a... Wait, what? Okay. That's weird. Ah! Oh, I didn't roll down the hill all the way. Oh well. Wait, is my soul gem in here? Yep, sure is. Well, we can't be having any of that now, can we? You're full too. One Wunderbar. Waterfall. See, this kind of looks like a Bob Ross painting right there. See the waterfalls living out now. Sometimes you just gotta scare them. Roll down the hill. Physics! Physics! Thank you, Woody. Much appreciated. Alright. My point hollow. Oh man, we're here already? That hardly seems laborious of a walk. Normally I usually fall off something and get stuck, but nope, not this time. Alright. Wrestling! Talking about wrestling! Wrestling! Whoa. Can't see. I can't see! I can't eat! Aaron! Gosh, I fall 2 feet out of the air and then I hurt. Honestly. Tomomania is running wild. What you gonna do when Tomomania comes for you? Dice.
You have the items. Contrary to all prediction. Once again, you defy the path set before you. However, what comes next is now unclear. If you wish to confront what is to come, I shall create the staff for you. Staff of Sheogorath holds the secrets of this realm.
I would think so.
As such, it requires a vessel that has witnessed dark secrets. The Sirta has seen things with her eyes that no mortal has. Because of this, her eye will serve well to contain that which the staff must hold. Now that you have both components, I can remake the shell of the staff. You possess the eye and the branch. Together, they shall form the physical shape of the
with
staff.
With an arrow to the face!
After I shape them into the staff, you must take it to the seat of power in the Shivering Isles. The Palace of Sheogorath.
The Palace of Sheogorath!
Imbue the staff with power from the Font of Madness. Soak the staff in the waters of the land, and it will open its full power to you. You have defied the expected and accomplished something that denies all logic. I must contemplate the error in my calculations. Now, take your treasure and leave me.
Whoa. That is quite a branch. Incomplete staff. Hey, that's a ripoff. I want the full staff. What? Ugh. Game. Why do you do that? Make my way to the Tree of Madness, the throne room, tap in the tree's power, begin my transformation. Right!
Inaction conflicts with your purpose. The longer you are here with me, the further the balance shifts toward
the enemy. Oh, wow.
There is no
very well put word, man.
You now hold the physical component of the staff of
Sheogorath.
Before it is complete, however, it must be imbued with power. It will draw its power from the waters.
I may defy the path, but you can't make me deny the path of an arrow to the knee. Oh no. Oops. Yeah, you know what's really funny about that Samuel guy? Not to go ahead and harp on him some more, because I'm honestly giving him way more attention than he deserves, considering how rude he is about the whole situation. I just saw this article about the top content producers on YouTube, the individuals, channels as a whole, and everything, and love him or hate him, PewDiePie was number two. The amount of money that he's bringing in based on his viewership is just unbelievable. And I actually learned a couple things on channel layout from him, so hopefully for those of you who actually do go to my YouTube channel to watch the archive or the other stuff that gets posted there, I hope it's getting progressively to be a little bit easier to navigate. But, you know, that guy, it's, Samuel needs to see that list, because there's a lot of people on there that goes against everything that he was saying. Samuel should run a public office. Now, see, interestingly enough, he also does political rants on that same channel. Some of them I agree with, other things I do not. He should stick to that. Because if he really wants to make money, that'd be the best thing for him to do. Abomination, go away. Whee! Flying off the mountain. Wait. He's still pink. That means he's still alive. Oh no, he's reforming himself. I'm over-encumbered. What bad time. I can't move. Get out of my face. Oh no, I was too close to the point of the explosion. I took damage. There was a point in time when I was a much lower level that I shot an arrow like that at point-blank range and totally killed myself because the area of effect of the, it was like AoE fire, and it was like a 20-foot fireball. Totally killed myself. I was fighting vampires too. Very anticlimactic. You subscribe to Samuel? Why would you do that? Subscribe to his channel and never watch any of his stuff. That'll infuriate him. You'll be able to see that on his audience retention and interactions. His engagement. I'm sorry, that's what it's supposed to be called. I mean, the really funny thing is, if you go back and watch the earliest of his stuff, the production values haven't changed that much. At least I'm trying to work towards something. I hope the new camera is a step in the right direction. Because this new camera actually has a tripod mount for it. And I'm actually going to see if I can't use the one that I normally use for conventions to set it up on. Because what I got it on is this a tiny little tripod on an end table right next to my chair. You know, for him, it looks like he's been using the same webcam ever since he started his channel. Okay, this guy. Hold on. Yeah, you don't have a name. You're... There we go. Bye-bye. Falling! Roll down the hill. Yeah! That's what you get. Lord Shagrath sends his regards. This is the most anticlimactic roll down the mountainside I've ever seen in my life. Alright, well, bye. Get lost. Oh no, now I can't make it back up. Damn it. Eh. There we go. What is this place? Galaxy Glue. No, I haven't watched the thing that you sent me a link for. If you want to go ahead and explain to everybody where that was supposed to be. Yeah, you're hostile. See, that's... Get out of my face. Nope, no time for you. Whoa! As you wish. Yeah, perhaps you can educate me on what that is right now. Fame? Somehow I have a feeling I might be coming here later. You subscribe to him because 6 million views, bro. Yes, that's his quote back to me on one of the last exchanges that I'm not allowed to criticize. Yeah, that's not true. I'm just saying your opinion lacks substance to give it credibility. Everybody's entitled to one. Super Saiyan Taliban looks like Alpha Unit. What, a Pomeranian? Alpha Unit is a dog of many forms. Sometimes he appears in the background of Darkstalkers. Let's see if I can go down the... Oh look, he's still rolling down the mountainside. Whee! Actually, gotta go fast. Eh. No, 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 I don't want to fall. There, see? Eh. No! Damn it. I want to live! Oh gosh. Welcome back to the Golden Saints. Surely the magic arrow propelled that magic physics. John Talbane. Oh, Super Saiyan Talbane. I'm sorry, I read that as Taliban. I didn't. Man, that's just. Oh, John Talbane looks like Alpha Unit? Yeah, if Alpha Unit got like a. Yeah, Alpha Unit's a weredog or something like that. It's magic missile. That's what I'm shooting. My bow shoots magic missile. Classy. Whoops. Where am I going? Nowhere fast! Ah! Galaxy Glue Jingle. Alright, now I am in front of the instant replay machine over here. The streaming machine is over there, so we won't be able to put this on screen share. So I will just have to watch it right here. Hold on. Wow! Galaxy Glue, you broke the vase. It's good as new. This is so... late 70s, early 80s. Oh, look who's a pretty little princess. Guys, you need to watch this clip. It's amazing. Whoa! Now the glue's sticking to everything. That's amazing. I'll have to watch the rest of it later, but that's pretty funny. Early 80s? Okay. Alright. Back towards the game! Over-encumbered. Joy! Okay. Well then. Askel, what do you think?
Ah, you're back. You may have noticed that we have a bit of a problem.
Kitty! And Bobo! What's happening, guys? How's it going? Happy Monday. 10:30 Eastern? What, tonight?
You're having a bit of fun with me. Very good. My lord, of course, noticed the font when you arrived in the palace. The font of madness? In the middle of the throne room? The font which is unaccountably covered with crystals.
Uh-oh. Happy freaking Monday! Okay, because if it was like tomorrow, knowing the luck of everything, of like, we're gonna go and fix something real quick, is never real quick, especially with the Xbox Infinity reveal tomorrow. Oh, speaking of which, I will be going ahead and streaming first impressions, and then I'll be fielding questions afterwards. So I know everybody seems to be doing that, but I figured, why the hell not? It's, an hour or two before my summer class starts, so no big deal. Why the hell not? Yeah, no spoilers. But I figure that'd be fun. Why the hell not? This fancy new camera. I'll be using the live event viewer on the 360 to watch it. Because that's actually, believe it or not, that's actually how I watched the presidential and vice presidential debates for extra credit in my public communications class in the fall semester. My expectations are fairly low too, but here's the thing: if it's better than what they did for the 360 on MTV, which actually, you know what? Hold on, let me check something real quick, because that actually raises a great question about that. Let me go and check to see when it when what was 2005 in May. Okay, because I remember they did something. I think it was May 17th, 2005. May 15th, 2005, I believe that's when they did the one for MTV. And it was basically Elijah Wood just walking around with a microphone, asking a bunch of celebrities that were playing the game, and you got to see maybe a clip of Perfect Dark, but it's mostly like 50 Cent and like P. Diddy going, "Yo, this thing's off the chain." I'm like, "Well, that's fantastic. You don't show us anything about the console." Then you had to wait till E3 to go see it, and that's when we saw everything that was going on. Anyway, here's what we know that's going to happen: the services are going to expand, the games are going to be announced. That's fantastic. All I really care about is what are they going to do about backward compatibility, if anything at all? Because digital content, they've invested so much in this platform that I want to know, am I going to be using it on the new system? And I've got two signs pointing to it. One, they would not have shrunk the 360 CPU GPU onto one chip if they weren't planning long term for it. That's what they did with the Model S. Sony did something very similar with the emotion engine in the PlayStation 2. They kept shrinking and shrinking and shrinking it, and it was in the launch unit PS3s. Also, too, Microsoft never dissolved the division that they created after buying a company called Kinexys that was specifically hired for doing the emulation program for the 360. Normally, they're pretty public about that kind of stuff. They never closed that division down. For all we know, they could have spent the last 3, 4 years working on an emulator program or a transitional program or some kind of a stopgap. Yes, Flying Glass, I want to see a new Killer Instinct. And quite frankly, at this point, I would settle for XBLA ports of the arcade versions of both of them right now. The next Xbox will display a red ring, followed by automated apologizing. Yes, the kitties. Actually, with the wider lens, you actually might see them running about. Actually, you can see their little cat condo in the background. Anyways, back to the show. Oh, Pazap, I'm sorry to hear about that. The 360's like the best console out of this generation that I've ever had, from the user experience all the way up to the game selection. Seriously, I haven't enjoyed a console this much since the Super Nintendo.
Order. The
Whoa,
taint
wait a
appeared
minute.
only a short time ago, but it has
The
spread
taint has
quickly.
spread
I fear
quickly.
that soon we will all be serving a new
I don't want to
master.
serve the new taint. No, that's terrible. Oh no, Two Worlds has invaded Oblivion.
Yes, his agents must have found a way to
Yes,
poison the
lady,
font
I'm a
of order.
fanboy, somebody who
Once the
actually
source of
enjoys the
madness
console
becomes
and
the
end
font
user
of order,
experience more than its
Chigalag is
competitors.
won.
Yes, that makes me a fanboy. Yeah, the taint. Oh no. Seven? Are you kidding me? I still had my launch unit 360 all the way up till I got my Modern Warfare 2 console, so that was from 2005 to November 2009, so yeah, quite literally 4 years. I'm not saying there wasn't a hardware problem. They would not have issued a public statement and dropped $1 billion on extending the warranty for all consoles from 3 years from the manufacturing date. I'm not saying that there wasn't a problem. I'm just questioning the conditions that they were stored in across the entire user base. Because like I said, launch units in any business, whether it be a car, television, game console, freaking washing machine, the failure rates tend to be pretty high. Either I've continually dodged the bullet every time I buy a new console at launch, or I took better care of it than most people. Ugh, eraser, no good, no bueno, that's bad. That's why I take my time whenever I use my PS3, because like I said, I've got a launching one, the one that has full backward compatibility. I am scared to death every time I turn that thing on, and scared to death every time I update the firmware because of its unbelievably bad failure rate for firmware updates, to the point that the BBC did an investigative documentary on it, to the point where Sony Europe said, please don't run it, we'll pay you to be quiet. That's bad.
This is true. Very little surprises me.
Triple H has a shovel? What?
Against the advance of order have left me astonished. Speechless. Indeed, it is your very success that must have led Jigalag to this unexpected avenue of attack. His usual approach is much less
imaginative. Am I fighting myself? Is that what this ultimately is becoming?
Somehow, the forces of order have poisoned the pools of mania and dementia that feed the tree. I suspect the traitor Syl. Jigalag has never had an original thought in his existence. Be that as it may, you will have to enter the fountainhead beneath the tree and find the source of the poison.
Poison!
Sheogorath's private sanctuary, where he would often meditate amidst the tame gnarls that tend the roots.
Oh, yeah.
Normally, the fountainhead is a peaceful sanctuary, but there's no telling what changes the Tent of Order back in
March.
Now I fear that the gnarls themselves may be accelerating the spread of order throughout the tree's roots. Be careful.
Do I have to go fight inside the giant Deku tree now?
The font flows with the sap of the Tree of Madness, which it draws up from deep beneath the palace. The fountainhead leads down to the pools of dementia and mania, where the insanity of the realm's inhabitants settles. Jigalag's minions must have introduced order into the very wellspring of madness. You must cleanse the pools, or order has won the war.
Well, this is lovely.
I live to serve.
And you serve to live. His throne, capital H, because he's a god. I get it. I get jokes. Whoa. Oh. I don't need that. Slickest Shadow. Everybody go follow Lady's RP account if that's your thing. I'm not alone in this tree! Elbow! Big kid, who comes after L? Bow! A! Those guys are preventing you from opening this door. Ha! Whoa. That looks like something out of, like, freaking XCOM. Side of one of the alien ships. It's gonna eat me if I go through it. How do... Wait a minute, maybe I'm... Oh, that's where I'm supposed to go. Activate Gnarled Chrysalis. Whoa! discovered the chrysalis that generates a tame gnarl cultivator. Perhaps these gnarls can help me halt this. Oh crap, and I killed one? Whoops. Yeah, it does look like a barnacle from Half-Life. That's an astute observation. Haha! I win! Oh boy! XCOM and Darksiders, yes. Everybody should play both of those games as well. I do want to get XCOM at some point and play that, because that game is just all sorts of boatloads of awesome sauce. Yes! No! Damn. A cultivator machine. Oh, the sector pods are the worst. Mind control is the devil! Yes! I have no idea if I'm going the right way or not. Whoa. Hey, I know what you are. You're bad news. Yeah, you fall on that. Just as Haskell suspected, Juggalag's priests are poisoning the tree of the root of madness. I've cleansed one of the minor pools, but I must find the pools of mania and dimension in order to save the tree. Bring back my arrow. Ooh, soul gems. Save the tree, shard of order, as opposed to madness shards. Ooh, Clive. Let's see. Clive, there we go. Power up! It was on sale on Steam a few days ago. Yeah, I'll get it on PC eventually when I get one as badass as ladies. You know, one that can take over the world. One that's like the HAL, like HAL 9000 or the Black Monolith from 2001 Space Odyssey. Right now, I gotta be very... hoping to find out on some... Wait, did stream die? What happened? Are you kidding? Twitch, what are you doing? Twitch. 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 Twitch, please. PLS. You're killing me. You are killing me. Twitch, you are killing me. Honestly. Yes, Twitch, go home. You're drunk. Unbelievable. Anyway, I totally forgot what I was saying, so that really doesn't matter. Samuel's trying to hack the stream. Anyway, what was I saying? Does anybody remember where everything blew up? Who keeps tweeting things? Jeez. Wait a minute. Kitty just sent me something. Holy crap, Kitty, I do not have that. That's actually pretty cool. Oh yeah, a new computer. Yeah. Now with consoles, I really just, you know, prefer to do that just because I know it's going to work with the computer that I have at the quality settings that I want to have it at. And actually, on a side note, that actually brings up another thing with the Xbox reveal tomorrow. I would really like to know if they are going to be employing HDCP, which is high definition content protection. I'm sorry, HDCP. I'm wanting to know if we're going to be employing that on the Infinity actively across all applications, or just when you play Blu-ray movies, because I can stream games on the PS3. It's just a giant pain in the ass because it only outputs over component. You can't do HDMI. It sucks. I hate that. Fortunately, the Wii U doesn't have a HDCP, and the 360 doesn't either. That's what I'm hoping for. That the Infinity only employs it when you're actually watching a video, as opposed to everything. Because if it does, it's going to suck. I don't want to have two sets of cables. Swapping cables is lame. New computer, Ark of the Covenant, the usual stuff. I've also been taking your calls about the Magna Carta. Buddy. No. Get out of here. Haha, you fall. Yes, Domino, because I like to watch movies in full 1080p over my gigantic display, and there is a marked difference between using HDMI and components. I have to switch to component if I'm going to be using it for the Elgato. Now, just to be clear, folks, there is a way to get around that, but it requires you buying a separate set-top box and getting a HDMI to DVI-D converter. Let them drink their fill of order. And that's more money that I don't have. Is that a spear? Oh gosh, is that... Yes, word man, now they've got my undivided attention. Soul gems! Give your soul gems! I'll swallow your soul! Who gets it? Give my arrow back. I want my arrow back, arrow back, arrow back. Wow! I think I'll just carry that just because it's worth a lot. Wild Sapphire, don't mind if I do! My arrow. Yes! Alright, where do I... How do Dementia? Chuck Z, I am almost expecting them at this point to have a Blu-ray drive in there. Not because they're trying to get on the bandwagon for having that be a media player, although I am willing to bet it'll also play Blu-ray movies, because you can actually have a Blu-ray drive and have it not play Blu-ray movies. The Wii U has done that. They've basically got all the technology that you would need in order to, have a Blu-ray drive, they just haven't licensed the codec to make it actually play Blu-ray movies. So what I'm expecting is that it's going to have a Blu-ray drive. What I do also expect, based on a rumor that I've seen come up 3 times, that all games will be required to be installed to the hard drive prior to playing them, which I am completely okay with that, because I do that on my 360 anyway, and there isn't a single game that doesn't benefit from that, so that's perfect. That will also definitely cut down on load times, especially when you're playing online, so you won't wait on that one person because if the data coming off the console is consistent across all users, that ultimately ends up with a better end user experience. So I'm okay with that 100%. And I just want to know if the HDCP is just going to be employed when you're watching Blu-ray movies and videos. Because going back to whether it's going to actually, about it using Blu-ray Drive to actually play movies and stuff like that, I mean, if they wanted the 360 to become a media machine that used Blu-ray, they wouldn't have just left regular DVD, because at this point in time, the console still doesn't need a mass storage device like that. Games haven't gotten that advanced. I mean, seriously, there's been... I think you can actually count on one hand how many games for the platform have used more than two discs. Because I'm thinking Lost Odyssey, that had four. L.A. Noire had three. Rage had three. Final Fantasy 13. I didn't play 13 Part 2, so I don't know if that was a multiple disc game or not. Clay, I have the HD DVD player. It's right over there. I watch V for Vendetta on it every November the 5th. That thing was awesome. The codec that they used for it, a codec called VC1. And Blu-ray actually supports that same codec, so it's just funny how that Blu-ray ended up using the codec of its chief competitor ultimately after it expired. I thought that was always interesting. Oh yeah, Blue Dragon, okay. Blue Dragon's awesome, I love that. Love to see another one. I don't know if it's ever gonna happen though. Anyway, the point is, people are freaking out. It's like, oh, the console will never get through its entire lifespan without, swapping a mass storage device, left to launch another system. No. We weren't at that point. Seriously, I don't even know of any PC games that have shipped on anything larger than a DVD. We weren't at that point then. We're starting to get to that point now. Especially with the Hey! Oh, hi there!
Hello.
Hi, let me turn your camera on. Bing! Hey, everybody! Look who has arrived.
Lady, fuck, I thought someone was calling me, and then I was like, wait, that's Tom's stream.
Oh no, I'm stuck. Oh no! Oh god, please, no, no, no!
Look, it's a Canadian.
A wild Canadian has appeared. What will you do? Befriend, run, offer tequila.
I think that falls under the befriend by offering tequila.
Okay, there you go. One thing leads to another.
Hi, lady. I don't know if you guys can hear it. It is now piss pouring rain and thundering out. Fireworks.
And then that sure didn't stop them from launching them, did it?
Oh no, it only just started to rain.
Oh, okay. Well, right after it's done.
I literally just came from across the street about 5 minutes ago. Like, I just put on a pot of water to boil to make some food, and I was just like, oh hey, it's raining. Fuck.
It's getting sulfur out of the air that they just blew up.
It was bad, but it was also kind of funny, because at one point, like, I was like, okay, I'm done. And then like, oh, there's nobody on the swings. Fuck this noise. I'm going to sit and swing, bitches. So yeah. I'm swinging. And the next thing I hear is this woman scream, and I look up, and I feel bad for laughing at this, but it was kind of hysterical. One of the fireworks tipped over and chased her.
Oh, no.
And all I hear is, ah, 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 and fireworks are coming behind her. I'm just like, I know this is bad and very dangerous, but the fact that she's screaming and these bright, colorful, lovely things are chasing her just makes me giggle.
That is hysterical. I wish you could have gotten that on video.
I'm just like, I'm just going to sit on my swing in the back here now.
Roman Candle War, I've done one of those before. That's effing dangerous. I was not the smartest.
I think Sam and Chad have had those fights.
Roman candle fights?
Yes. Thanks, Chuck. He goes, oh, it's just Kanan.
What? At least
then he's like, hi, Kanan, way stupidly. Like, okay, whatever. I haven't even had...
That was actually the first thing that when the stream started, it's like, where's Kanan? She's probably asleep. And then we started seeing, you know, pictures of your fireworks. Mm. It's like, that's right. It's a holiday.
Yeah, I was taking a shower and I could hear the fireworks go off. I'm like, these sound retardedly close. I'm going to go and investigate. So I'm just like, oh, they're launching them right at the playground across the street.
Right at the playground.
Mm-hmm.
You just hear them over a PA system shouting, danger close, firing for effect.
Mm. And I will be right back because I got to go check on my food. So,
Are you having craft dinner?
Spaghetti. I said that.
Spaghetti. Yes. Did you? You said you were putting on a pot of water. I didn't
to
know
make
was...
some spaghetti for food. Anyways, food. Be right back.
F-O-O-D. Food. Lunch is
actually,
best
you know
time
what?
Of
I'm gonna
day.
Leave the microphone on so you guys can fucking hear the thunder that's going on right now.
Crash, bang, boom. Lunch is best time of day. Saw you at the buffet. You are big and I'm small. You're as wide as I'm tall. F-O-O-D, food. G-O-O-D, good food. I had a coworker that would play that on the loudspeaker every time you would go to the one break at the Walmart that I worked at back when I was in high school. Yeah, he was an eccentric individual. I'm even going the right way. And that was the one thing about the Fallout games, you could at least zoom the map all the way out of when you were in the interior of the building. We have been thunderstruck. Falafel? Yeah. Yum. Yeah, Chad setting the tree on fire. That was pretty amazing. Hey, Haskell. I think we're good.
At this time, you have enough to go on.
Oh, hush.
With the pools cleansed, the font of madness will soon be restored. There's no time like the present to finish your journey towards
Godhood!
In life.
Right. Activate the Fountain of Madness. I have immersed my staff in the... That's not suggestive at all. Jeez. Apparently rich people... search for handicapped people to pay so they can post a family. Wow! Oh, man. Not just EA Sports, just EA anything in general. It sounds like Nintendo actually cut them a check to actually get Mass Effect on there at the beginning, and then all of a sudden, oh, by the way, haha, just kidding! Whee! Fly away! You know, nothing to do here, .jpg. That is, wait. Clay, I've never heard of that before in my life. That is quite disturbing. Whoa.
My lord, our Mazel Zuda sent me to find you. She requests your immediate
Where
assistance.
Where is she?
I don't know, my lord. She only said it was a matter of the gravest import to the security
well, that is
of the realm.
The end of order. Well, everything seems to be going fine. Ghost armor. Dynamite. Dynamite! I love that show. Good times. So, what is this ghost armor that you are speaking of? Yeah, Red Punk, that Samuel fella's a real jerk. Oh, she's here.
My lord, I'm glad to see you. We have a developing situation that requires your
attention. Oh, really?
Order. An obelisk has activated just outside the palace. I've ordered my Orioles to engage the enemy. I expect that this is the beginning of the final assault. The cursed usurper Jigalag himself may even take the field before the end. What are your orders, my lord?
I will lead the attack myself.
It will be our great honor to fight by your side, my lord.
Yeah, that guy is really a piece of work. Whoa. Like, out here? Holy crap, they really did. Hold still while I shoot you. And I missed wildly. Oh my god, please get out of the way. There we go, there's one. Entaro Adun! Wait a minute, wrong game. Oh crap. Okay, that's enough. Crap. Beat him with my bare hands. That's right, stupid things. That's two. Yes. Why would I ever say no to that? Honestly. There. Crap. No. I really do hope the archery is better in Skyrim, because not being able to shoot with precision in a combat situation like this is very annoying. Oh god, there's another one? Come on, ladies, let's do this. I hear someone, but I don't see someone. Came in. There. Beat the crap out of you. Boom. Fall to your death. Die 1,000 deaths. Ha ha! Get out of here, sucker! Whoa. Holy crap, who and what is that?
You all disturb, but you are no Daedric
Prince. That Jigalag? Holy crap, I almost killed Jigalag with one arrow. And good night. Well then. Whoa.
Enough. I am beaten. The Grey March is ended.
What is happening?
For millennia, this drama is unfolded, and each time, I have come to this land, only to be transformed back into that gibbering fool, Sheogorath. It was not always so. Once I ruled this realm, a world of perfect order. My dominion expanded across the sea.
Bye-bye, lady. Good night.
With each passing era, the other princes, fearful of my power, cursed me with madness, doomed me to live as Sheogorath, a broken soul reigning in a broken land.
Okay.
Once each era, I was allowed my true form, conquering this world.
We got a live phone call.
And each time I did,
put it on speakerphone!
The curse was renewed, damning me to exist as Sheogorath. Now, though, you have ended the cycle. You now hold the mantle of madness and Jigalag is free to roam the voids of oblivion once more. I will take my leave, and you will remain here, mortal. Mortal, king, god. It seems uncertain. This realm is yours. Perhaps you will grow to your station. Fare thee well, Sheogorath, Prince of Madness.
Fascinating. Hey, I am the Mad God. Achievement unlocked. Yeah. You're live on Tom Chat. What is your name, caller? Caller, go ahead. Can we, like, revive all these saints? Because I feel really bad that they died when, presumably, Jigalag showed up. Damn it. I'm sorry, ladies. You fought your best. Whoa. Syl, you bitch. Oh, you're not Syl. You're the court healer. Okay.
Are you injured, Lord? Do you require my services?
Services. Yes, heal me now.
Of course, Lord.
Whoa. She's got the healing touch. Askel, talk to me.
You've done it. Well done, Lord Sheogorath. I never doubted you for a moment.
What to say here about all the
now,
women
of
are dead?
There is business to
attend. A lot of the golden saints died when Jigalag showed up.
There are matters that deserve your attention.
Man, you suck.
As Lord of this realm,
he spawned right on top of them, literally.
Bound Jigalag?
Not in a good way.
Aww. That's the saddest types.
You may request any of the golden saints.
So did people enjoy hearing thunder and lightning if they could?
To accompany you.
I couldn't hear anything, but it was cool that we did that.
You may also summon entertainment to your throne room.
Wait, you could hear it?
Found this most invigorating. Speak with me if you wish entertainment. You also have the ability to affect the weather in your realm.
The weather?
As it is an extension of yourself, it will often have an effect on you as well. You also have the benefit of Sheogorath's protection. Cast this upon yourself, and if your life is threatened, you will be returned to your castle.
Neat.
Many of these abilities, Lord, are rooted in the magics of the Isles. Should you choose to leave this realm, they will not likely function.
Sheogorath's duties.
Your first duty is to attend to the needs of your subjects. You will find that there are constant threats
Thunder
to the
cakes?
Residents of the Isles. Your job is to
protect
them.
I think he kiboshed that one, Wordman.
Yourself. Or sending your armies to take care of it for you.
Earthworm Joe. Entertainment in Oblivion confirms strippers. I'll build my own realm with blackjack and hookers.
It's
in other words, golden saints.
In the Shivering Isles.
Dark seducers, if you know what I mean, not JPEG.
Oh, please. They will seduce you for your wallet. That's it. You're not getting anything
else. Send for a dancer. Oh, boy.
As you wish.
Oh, dear. Here we go. Dark Seducer Escort? That's not suggestive at all.
Uh-oh. Someone let that James person in again. We gotta stop leaving the gate open.
Hey! Wild Epic Game music has appeared. Dancer. Oh, she's got the sweet dance moves. Look at her go. This is awkward to watch. What is this? Sheogorath's Regalia. I'm invisible! That's just great. Here, let's throw on the regalia and see what it looks like.
I love the regalia on the woman.
That's what we're about to find out. Oh! Not to sound offensive, but it kind of looks like someone cut up a some drapes. It's kind of frilly, multiple layers. Doesn't look good with the hood, though. Let's take that cowl off. There we go.
Raymond's ardent soul. That's not Shaegor's regalia.
Yeah, that's what it says. It's... Oh, raiment. Whoops, hold on. There we go. Oh!
I told you.
Okay, that's better.
Well, and also they're saying, look behind his throne for something.
Look for throne.
Look
that's
behind
the
throne.
That's not even the outfit. That actually... That's pretty badass. I want to see someone cosplay as that. You know what? The patterns on the backside of the dress, like right where your knees would be, kind of looks something like Hylian almost. That's pretty badass. Take the Ring of the Grey off because that's... Take the Ring of the Khajiit off. There we go. Oh, the dance is over! No! There we go.
Did Zelda dye her hair?
The Zelda Dyer hair. Sure.
I stand ready, Lord.
Yeah. There we go. Oops. How do zoom? Oh, there we go. Yeah, it was left and right trigger. Ah! Nope. So awkward. There we go. Yes. I go into battle like this. That's actually a pretty bitchin' outfit.
Always.
Okay, so you said there's something... in Khajiit. Ring of the Grey. Quicks.
Yeah, and at least it doesn't make her boobs look sad anymore.
Yeah, exactly.
That she looks like she's got semi-decent boobs now. She's got padding.
Yeah, it's very uplifting if you know what I mean.
Red Punk is very bummed. Well, a bit bummed that there will be no new Skyrim DLC.
Yeah, you know what? I really thought that they were going to do at least one more before that came out. Because they did the same thing with Fallout and Oblivion. I'm not seeing it. What are you guys looking for?
I don't know. Somebody said something about a sword, and they said, look behind his throne.
I'm not seeing it. I am seeing the Fountain of Madness, though. Staff of Shaggarath removed. Staff of Shaggarath added. Sure. I'm not seeing a sword, guys. Entrance of the tree.
Unless it did something. Unless that's for something for your sword, or I mean your staff.
I can't see. It's too dark. Eh. Where's my air? Back of the tree. What am I supposed to go into the tree now?
Mm-hmm.
Wait, hold on. Don. This is a babe. What is... What? Don, what are you doing? Don, stop. Peanut Butter Gamer is copying me! Hey! How dare he! Poser, adjust hipster glass. It's on the podium. What, in the tree? Hold on, Dynamite. I don't mean to... For those of you who saw my tweets earlier that I was using Gorilla Glue on the mic stand, it appears to be holding because I'm not fidgeting with the microphone right now. It's on the podium behind it. Oh, great. I'm over-encumbered again. Eh. What? There's nothing on the podium. I didn't press one. There's nothing on the podium. What's supposed to be on the podium? Red Punk. That's pretty funny. We'll do a ladder match. Because I know he started doing it recently. What the fuck? It was there for me. What was it supposed to be, dude? Because if it was, like, anything short of a ranged weapon, it really wouldn't have been of any great use to me. Activate Night Over the Helmet. Chalice of Reversal. focus crystal. Oh, look, all the neat little things that I collected over the course of my adventure. The Inquisitor's Cage. Replica Gatekeeper Weapon. Ah, you're right. There should have been something there. With all the podiums going around the room. Hello, Dancer.
Yes? I wouldn't be caught dead at Sickly Bernice's. Though I imagine her.
The Sword of Jigalag, a massive weapon carried by Jigalag, the David Prince of Order after defeat. Jigalag, the sword will appear on the pedestal in the back of New Shadows. It's leveled. Appearance depends on the level of time of the player. Jigalag spawn, in practical terms, the sword is essentially an enchanted claymore capable of damaging creatures with useless normal weapons. Well, I'm level 47, which would probably explain why he was so big. I don't know if they expected me to have me like max level like that.
You wish an escort, Lord?
Oh yes, baby, escort me.
Of course, sire.
Can I take the seducer with me? Oh, she's smiling.
You wish an escort, Lord.
Oh,
what the fuck,
yeah.
James is hailing near you?
Light and dark, baby. Working together.
Yes, is.
Defender.
It seems all is peaceful in
the
Shivering
Isles. All right.
In lightning, as always.
Well, let's go back outside and see if I missed something out there in the palace grounds. Maybe the sword fell. Possibly. Maybe it's still out there. Oh, it looks like one of the saints has recovered. Ugh. Body parts everywhere, though. Oh, wait, Jigalag bodies disappeared after I killed them, so it's not like it would have mattered.
Lord Sheogorath, your aureoles stand true. The aureole are yours to command.
Well, let's see here. I do like having a full set. Poof. Arrows. Golden bow. Already have a golden bow, though. Oh man, I can't loot her armor? Dang it.
Nope.
What about her? Oh man.
The seducers, you can take their armor, but the saints, you can't get their armor.
That's unfortunate.
Which is bullshit.
Because I was given a seducer armor, and we all know how well that turned out. Because I am the most tragically white elf chick ever.
Man, sucks to be in your neighborhood, James. Apparently it hailed, so it was hailing like crazy over by him. It looks like it snowed
Uh-oh.
Out. He's like, but people
Uh-oh.
Are still setting up fireworks.
It looks like they want some alone time. They've got that look. Oh, boy! Oh, that's fantastic. Oh, let me go out. Let me go back inside. Maybe the sword came back. The damage is 24. The sword is in my pants. I'm sorry, there are no
So if they had a baby,
there.
Would it be a golden seducer or a dark saint?
Here we go. The Sword of Jigalag. There it is. Holy crap, this thing is huge. Dude, it looks like Sting. The blade is glowing when danger's nearby. Let's see. Can I use it?
Someone highlight Tom's face back there.
Holy crap, hold on. Look. It's so big. It's going above the top of the frame of the screen.
It's a claymore. Of course it's big.
No, there are claymores that are short enough that you can actually see it. Hold on. I have to... Hold on a second. This is... Ah! Stop going into third person when I don't want you to. Hold on. I have to see this. Hold on. This is too funny. Where's Sheogorath's regalia?
Yeah.
Okay, there we go. I'm gonna take out the
really?
Ring of the grave. Take out that. And we're gonna take off the hood.
You're gonna get all fancied up for your big sword?
Yes. Oh my, it's almost as tall as me. Oh my goodness. This thing is giant! Oh my god! And it's transparent and translucent. That is amazing. Wow, that is truly something else. Hold on, ladies, back up. I want to take a swing at this. Whew, that's got some reach to it. That is something else. That's pretty funny. All right.
She-Ra 2013. Do not insult She-Ra.
She-Ra's awesome. Not even kidding. Those of you who think otherwise, y'all can just go out to hell. Alright, I'm gonna put that back where I found it, because I'd rather be here in the realm where I know I can find it rather than have it in my house and completely forget that I have it. Pity it's the size that it is. I'd love to have that in the display case in my house in Skingrad. Yeah, there we go. That's pretty boss. It almost looks like a glass sword. Probably lasts longer than three swings, though. Yeah, the glass weapons. The defense is pretty good. The offensive capability, unless if we're talking about arrows, not so much. Alright, ladies, where are we going? I wonder if they can follow me back to Tamriel. That'd be sweet. I think, short of that guy that does the pearls. Yeah, let's see if this guy actually woke up. Otherwise, well, I guess we'll head back to Tamriel, and then I guess keep the big game going, because, you know, guys, I haven't finished the main quest. You know, there's that wonderful little quest to close all the Oblivion Gates. Remember, if you go and you finish the main story, that quest goes away. I haven't been inside an Oblivion Gate yet, other than the ones that are required to do that by subquest. So, oh man, they've got magic. That's awesome. That seriously looks like a radioactive goo from Half-Life. My Geiger counter going off. So how was your day, Kynan? Was it better than yesterday?
I had brunch with Audrey and Tanner. And then I saw fireworks.
Would you have a brunch?
I had blueberry pancakes. Oh, delicious. And I'm freaking James out because he can see the stream in the mirror.
Yeah, I just looked over and saw that. Dude, hold still. Get back here.
So, you have the pearls? Or perhaps any other...
Okay, this guy's quest is completely screwed up, so...
Excuse me. I have important things to do.
Ugh. This is really like turns. Like, I have a kink in my neck and it sucks.
Well, these two look like they were ready to kill something. Okay, so, let's see here. What else is...
Man, either he's really short or those ladies are fucking tall.
They appear... They're taller than me. By a good bit. I had to say they're about 6-something, which I'm perfectly okay with. You know what? Hold on. Where did he go? Oh, great. Now he's inside. You know what? Let's save real quick. And find out what happens. We just go ahead and knock this guy off. Ladies, you're dismissed.
Shall I continue with you, Lord?
Oh, I don't want you to wait here out in the cold. Yes, keep following me.
By your...
Well, that's just rude. I mean, come on now.
Freaking James. Tall girls, big smiley.
Yes. There's just so much more to hug. Oh man, now he went back outside. Dang on it. There he is. Oh, I've still got bare hands.
Those are little pop gummies.
All right.
Ah, went to the convenience store and I bought one of those, like, miscellaneous candies.
Candy! So give me candy!
It's pop.
Give me candy! Bubblegum and taffy! Whoa! No. His heart? Okay. I can climb my arrow again.
And James says Tom style and hairdo, by the way.
Who, me or you?
You! James said that Tom style and hairdo, by the way.
I haven't done anything different, but thank you. It's one of those things that my hair has a mind of its own. Especially when there's humidity, my curls come out like crazy. And I haven't always been a big fan of them.
No, not the ones with liquids in them.
Huh?
Oh, they asked if it was the ones with liquid in them. I said no.
No.
Have you dealt with Dude, take his heart!
I'm not getting yeah, I did take his heart. For some reason, I think you it might hurry be parts. Get rid of him.
Mm-hmm. So, you've dealt with the problem, eh? I like the sound of that. How do I know he won't come back?
Oh, I have proof. Give heart.
Very nice. In fact, I may be able to make use of this particular item. Seems like a nice potential replacement.
Potential replacement for
You've
what?
You've more than earned your reward. I believe a bit of a bonus is in order. Well done.
It better be something good. Gold, really? Ugh, you're at that point in Elder Scrolls when you get disappointed by a tangible reward of gold or silver because you have so much of it that it's laughable.
Goodbye.
Well. Yeah. Yeah, your redness is really shining through tonight, what everybody's saying, and I will definitely have to agree with them. Which is awesome! Alright, Cutter. Where is Cutter? Am I in the right shop? No. Oh, I'm right across the street. How convenient.
No, you're correct, James. Is it just me, or in Oblivion, everyone's face looks too small for their head? Like, no, that's Oblivion.
Almost all of them are like that, yeah. I do understand that the majority of the human character model problems get resolved in Skyrim. Man, they're always looking down at me.
Shall I continue with you?
Hey, Wordman. By any chance, do you know a William Hoffman?
Give yourself from smoke. Hey, Cutter, what's happening?
Why visit that other smith? Piercing flesh with my blades doesn't satisfy
you. You're overdoing the lipstick again here, but other than that, you're doing all right.
What do you desire?
Let's see here.
Oh, just that petition that I've been tweeting about. There is a William Hoffman that just signed it, like,
sure. What is your important artery? I'd love to have a madness armor.
How do I?
I heard Thaden's heart. I'd love.
Whoops, ran out of madness, or I think I left the rest of it in Tamriel. Hold on. Let's see. How over-encumbered am I? Oh, not by a lot. I can make it back home with this. I just need to cast another spell! Or, I can go ahead and put on, see, I'm not the Gray Fox! Capital idea! La 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 la. Alright, ladies, you're dismissed. Man, they really look like they want to be doing something else right now.
Check on Twitter, Wordman. I posted it on there.
Shall I continue?
Yeah, she's
with
been
you,
talking
Lord?
About it for the last couple of days.
Well, it's as bullshit. Wish, what's going on?
At the ready.
Did you actually read that, Tom?
Yes, I did.
You wish an escort,
I would love
Lord.
An escort, but not right now.
As you wish, I stand
there
at the
go.
Ready.
Boom. Okay, now they can go back to the castle and I can leave the realm without fear they might get hurt. Unless if it's a time of need. Because it said I had to defend the realm, which I assume would probably be like some wide-scale attack. That'd be pretty cool. Alright. Well, I think that's all the major stuff to do here for the time being. So let us return back. Oh man, I haven't done Manea's Razor yet? Well, folks, it appears we have plenty to do here. Manea's Razor was really weird, that giant beating heart at the end. Ugh. If you wanted to contract horrific hemophilia, you could definitely do it that way. Eat that heart. Yeah, they're just staring passionately into each other's eyes. Right, sending escorts to Talon's room at SGC. Well, if you're gonna do that, make sure they're redheads.
Jeez.
Hey, I'm sorry, not really. Of the female persuasion, before somebody goes ahead and makes a correction. Alright, let's get back to the gate. Which is back here. Well, that was fun. It only took 10 weeks. You know, and it's also interesting that there's plenty of more of this kind of shenanigan to go around because I haven't done Mass Effect, I haven't done Skyrim. Haven't done a lot of stuff. Oh, that reminds me, guys, tomorrow Vicky is planning on hosting a Street Fighter Fight Night. So if you have Super Street Fighter 4 on the 360, be sure to be watching for it about 8 p.m. Eastern Standard. That's about the time she's planning to start it. Just may as well throw that out right now. Cannon, are you doing Fatal Frame tomorrow?
I finished Fatal Frame, remember?
I mean, F-Stick. What the F were you playing?
Alice?
Yes, thank you, I'm sorry. Why did I forget that? Because
I don't know why you forgot that, but potentially... if Domino's internet doesn't dick out on us, me, him, and Lady are going to try for some Dark Souls.
Dark Souls?
If that's a bust, then I'll go and play Alice.
Nice. Yeah, I don't know
James,
why
I think Kelly's going to need security at SGC.
No.
James, why
no.
Do you think I'm also avoiding the poolside?
Dude, too much respect. How dare you guys. Anyway, now, I'm really surprised I forgot what you were playing because I was all talking about the Cheshire Cat and knowing my favorite line from the franchise came from him in the first game. Did you play the first one on PC or did you play it when it got re-released on PS?
Re-released because when it initially came out, I didn't have a PC that could properly run it.
Yeah, it was running on Quake 3 back then, and for those people who have no concept of what it was, think of it, Quake 3 when it first came out was the... Crisis game engine of its day. It was pretty hardcore. And Alice happened to be one of the many games that came out in the year 2000 that was running on it. I have not finished Fatal Frame yet. I don't even think I'm through the second day.
No, I don't think you are.
I am very, very far behind because of my arch nemesis. Ladders. But I will finish it. I started the race, it's only proper to end it. Now, were you playing Fatal Frame via PSN download, or were you playing it on disc?
I was playing it PSN. Okay. Which is funny, because since I did like a bum rush of Fatal Frame 2, I think I'm the only person that actually streamed all the glitches that's in Fatal Frame 2, because if you haven't been paying attention, it got yanked off of PSN.
Oh, dear.
Now, Domino found something interesting, which... Well, I was just going to say, is like, Domino found something that might explain why there was such a bad, like, port.
It's not it a port, it's an emulation. There's a difference.
Anyways, we think it might be a port copy from the Xbox, because on the ESRB ratings, it says the director's Fatal Frame 2 director's cut, and only the Xbox got the director's cut.
Well, it also could be the exact same situation that happened with Silent Hill 2, where it's the same code, and they just ported it over and just made the
they didn't have the actual final coding. Like, they didn't back up the final coding for the Silent Hills. That's why they were fucked up.
No, I'm talking about how the Greatest Hits version of the PS2 version of Silent Hill 2 had all the content that was previously only on the Xbox One version of it. I'm saying, what's the standard reason that they didn't do that?
Either way, there's issues in the game. So.
I mean, here's the thing. The emulator that they used on the 80GB 4 USB port PS3 wasn't perfect. They claimed it had 80% backward compatibility, but what they neglected to mention was it had to be the first run of the game. It couldn't be the special edition SKUs because they had a different release process, and it couldn't be the Greatest Hits version. So that kind of narrowed it down in a big way. And I had a lot of customers return to use games that they bought because of that issue. So I'm wondering if that... Oh, my God, I'm overcoming it. And I just cast the wrong spell. So, hi, guys. How you doing? I'm wondering if any of those factors have played into it. The reason why I was asking if you were playing it on PSN or not was... For some reason, the Elgato in XSplit is stretching all standard definition content. Like, it's taking it and stretching it into a 16:9 aspect ratio when it shouldn't. Which is really weird, because that's an option that's actually in the regular streaming software itself, and you can uncheck it, but for some reason it's doing it by default. So the fact that you're actually playing it in HD on your PS3 is making the difference of it being broadcasted in its native aspect ratio as opposed to what's happening. I just happened to look at that Fatal Frame was a widescreen game for the Xbox, but for you it was like, why is it working for her and not for me? Poor K. Maria!
Don't even talk to poor K. Maria. That, did you actually finally watch that clip?
No, I watched it a while ago. I just got the email in my inbox saying that it was just now posted on ScrewTech, which is totally not true.
Yeah, I know.
That's right, kids. Email notifications are now officially 28 days behind schedule.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, DesignZillas, please fix it. 1-800, please help. Where the F is the realm?
At the lab, I'm hearing some people still attempt to shoot off fireworks in the rain. Like, that's dangerous. And... a waste of fireworks.
The PS1 emulation isn't perfect. Final Fantasy is impossible to finish. Really? Oh my god, that sucks. Especially in that game. I don't care what anybody says about 8. At least it had emotion in it about things.
I liked 8.
Yeah, it gets a hard time. Spoonie.
Like, yeah, it's like, I
gave it a hard time.
Especially Spoonie. Oh yeah, it's like... I don't know, I find that 8 got, like, unnecessarily shit on. Like, really?
The magic system
because,
was broken.
Because you actually
kind of
gave a character feelings?
Yeah, feels.
It's like, oh my god, heaven forbid the main male character actually ends up having feelings.
Yeah. It came off much more, organically than what happened with, Cloud and Aerith. Or Eris, depending on where you're from.
I go with Eris, because as the comic puts it, he goes, I don't want to sound like a retard with a lisp.
Yeah, well, it's like how I can't say, who's the Norse god of thunder?
Hmm?
Who's the Norse god of thunder? Who is,
Odin?
No, that's
Thor, you mean?
Who?
Thor?
Who? No, that's what I'm saying. It's the same damn problem.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, great. It's dark. I can't see. Wait a minute. Am I on the way?
Aerith was a retcon.
Aerith was a retcon? Right, so you can't say, you know, his name without having sounding like a Riri either, so it's I have to go ahead and say his full name to avoid that. Tor Odinson. So, you know, it's just, yeah. And the funny thing is, I actually remember earlier in life not having that problem, so I don't know what happened along the way that prevented me from doing so.
Oh no, I'm just reading what Chuck says. FF8 has always been a mixed bag for me. I like the character design, the overall feel of it. Could not stand the draw system.
Yeah, that thing is broken as hell. You can totally get all the magic you need in one game from one person, if you have the patience for it.
Yes, Red Punk, I saw that video too. That was actually pretty awesome.
Oh, yeah, the game theory episode?
Yep, that was actually pretty good.
I can't remember who I linked that to and said, oh, it's, you know, this is, it's Final Fantasy 7 Day, this is the day that Aeris died, and it's like, well, you know, you should really know that Cloud is responsible for death, not Sephiroth. What? So I link it to it, and he says, get back to me when you're done watching it. I get a text message from him 15 minutes later, he said, you're a fucking monster, I hate you and everything you stand for.
You're a fucking monster.
Yeah, pretty much. And it's like, it's not just the theory, it's a game theory. Thank you, MatPat. I thought Zebeth was the language that they spoke. Wow, Tamriel. It's been a while. Oh, what a lovely sunset.
Wow, Domino, that went dark.
How many games can you
he's
say
like,
that?
No, he's like, it's no life if she couldn't have do anything to stop Cloud from drowning her. I'm like, wow.
Never mind the
so you're
paralysis.
Saying Cloud put her out of her misery.
Stay away from me.
Wow.
I've already spent too much time.
I'm pretty sure that's what the cure spell is for.
You can't see me. You can't see me.
Shadowmere. Shadowmare's best pony. My pony can swim.
Correct, Chex.
Look at my horse. She's amazing. Whee! Sploosh! This pony can swim. This pony can tread water, too. Whee! Good pony. Yeah, okay, seriously, let's have a discussion while I swim back to my house.
Because I feel like this discussion's gonna go on for fucking ever.
No, it won't. It's just, you know, just a very simple one, and it's mostly an opinion. Do Phoenix Downs work on every character? Or was it
they
just a
should.
Plot? Okay. So do you think their body has to be intact for it to work, or could they, say, lose an arm and still be using it?
Well, see, here's the thing, too. Like, standardly, in most of the Final Fantasy games, when the... In a battle, when a person's killed, they're KO'd, they're knocked out. So it's really more or less stating that they're not dead, they are unconscious.
And mute? What?
Wow, Pizzap. Harsh.
Why would you want to mute in that this wonderful discussion that we're having here? Because, like, that's the thing. It's not like you don't have Phoenix Downs at that point in the game. And I'm pretty sure at least one person knows at least life level 1 by then.
Mm-hmm.
What the crap? Was Aerith's death a MacGuffin? Was her death merely just a plot device? Because we all know it was written in as a response to, oh gosh, what was his name? The director from Mistwalker Studios that did Blue Dragon, Lost Odyssey, and The Last Story. What was his name?
Okay, I see why Pizzap did it. He said, I said earlier, I haven't played most of the Final Fantasy games.
Oh, don't worry. It's that, unless if you really, really, well, I have a very skewed opinion of 7. I think it's probably the most undeserving of all the praise that it gets. But long and short of it, you know, something bad happens. And a lot of people are saying this is completely reversible, and other people are saying, no, it's not. I'm just saying common Final Fantasy logic says if a person is dead, you should be able to revive them. Same thing with General Leo. I felt that was a huge cop-out.
Mm-hmm.
But then again, I thought his passing, which was significantly more tragic than Aeris's, because you keep hearing about this legendary general throughout the entire game, and you see him, and he's standing up to it, and then it's like, oh man, I want him to join my party, because everything in the game indicates that he is going to join you at some point. And then, when he does, he steps in to save you, and then he's stabbed in the back, and that's the end of it. You get to play here with him for a grand total of 5 minutes.
Unless you had my glitched out cartridge. And then Celeste would turn into General Leo in battle.
They actually covered that on Pop Fiction on how to do it intentionally. So the fact that your game did it without the aid of a game genie is pretty damn remarkable.
Mm-hmm. And like I said, Terra turned into a brunette with white and pink armor.
Oh yeah, the wine bottle explosion. Forgot about that. Oh, speaking of 8 and 7 and all that fun stuff, Final Fantasy VIII is supposedly getting another PC re-release, if the ESRB is to be believed. A Square, still waiting on my Steam version. Maybe I'll stream it. Remind myself why I don't like it that much. How to be epic! Holy crap, what's going on, dude? Alright, back to my humble abode here.
It's raining out, Mal, and it's thundering and lightning, but before that I was watching fireworks at the playground across the street. Also, I got to play on the swing. I'm an adult, ladies and gentlemen.
Damn right. There's a difference between growing up and growing old. You can grow up, just never grow old. Never stream the PC version, want to hear that MIDI music. I will gladly take the MIDI music over the fact that I can actually have it in 16:9 aspect ratio, you know, in HD. So that way when you're actually in battle, the people don't look like five polygons. I can't stand that.
Wordman, I really wish that, like they did with Final Fantasy 1 and 2 and 4... I wish they had made a PSP copy of Final Fantasy VI. That would have been amazing.
Yes.
Because in my, like I said, in my personal opinion, I love the addition of like the complete collection of Final Fantasy IV on the PSP the best, because it feels like Final Fantasy IV. Don't get me wrong, the DS copy was fucking gorgeous and amazing, but for somebody that grew up with the original 4 or 2 up here in North America for the longest time, the PSP edition feels like that game. Yep, and yes, I would have loved to see, you know, Final Fantasy V and Final Fantasy VI get a beautiful upgrade for the PSP. Chucks, I could have easily launched myself if I wanted to.
Oh,
I just didn't feel like dying.
Calvin and Hobbes style. Whee! The Ring of the Viper Eye is a quest item. Interesting. Ah, yes, the Master Retort. I remember dropping a whole bunch of crap in here that didn't belong in the stream.
Red Plunk, I personally don't feel that Final Fantasy needs to die. I think it needs to actually get back to its roots instead of trying to be a fucking movie.
Yeah.
And basically just, it feels to me now that Final Fantasy as a franchise is copping out to casual gamers. They're making it, you know, a little bit too easy. Like, I mean, I'm sorry, I haven't played Final Fantasy 13 too, so again, I don't know how it is, but one of the things that pissed me off in 13 was the oh, hey, I'm in a dungeon, let's walk in a straight fucking line. There was no real exploration.
Yeah, there's a difference between making your game approachable and then just toning it down to effing simpletons. And
exactly, like, let's press X to win.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of people like to blame it on the fact that it got ported to the 360 as a reason that it got dumbed down so badly. Guys, if you actually go ahead and research the history for 13, it actually started out as a PS2 game.
Mm-hmm.
So somewhere along the line, when they decided to go ahead and change, it sounds like a lot of stuff got left on the cutting room floor.
Yeah, shorten the cutscenes. Another thing, too, I know this one gets some shit, too, but I actually enjoyed Final Fantasy XII.
You know what? That's the only other one that I would actually give a shot. Because for
Mal.
It appeals. What?
Oh, no, he's like, sorry, Final Fantasy XIII ranting. Wake me up when this is over.
The best part of 13 was when Lightning bitch slapped the shit out of Hope. And then I said, well, I'm done with this game. Like, it needs to get back to what it was. It's totally okay to, you know, have a new cast every single time. The fact that Tetsuya Nomura had nothing to do with Final Fantasy IX was probably the reason why I liked it so much better than anything that was before it and anything that has been since it.
See, Eraser, I didn't mind the battle system because the battle system was very reminiscent to Final Fantasy XI. So, anybody who's played 11 and actually enjoyed it, I found that 12 was a Final Fantasy that was like an offline MMO. That's kind of how it was.
I remember Penny Arcade describing the combat as being masturbatory. Because it was almost on autopilot, because you played like an MMO. Which is...
Yeah, but the thing is, you could take it off autopilot.
Okay, because like you see, because that's like the majority of the biggest complaint about 13 was that you were like middle management in a company, that all that your job in life was to approve or disapprove projects before they got passed up to upper management. You know, A to confirm, X to cancel, you know, crap like that.
Yeah, no, it's like, I actually enjoyed 12. It was a fun game. I made Ash my fucking paladin.
I really don't know who that is. There's also a rumor going around that that might get an HD re-release, so I never actually...
What might... Oh, 12?
Yeah, because with,
Wouldn't
what's
surprise
it called,
me.
10 Part 2 getting roped into it, why not? And to be honest, I'm perfectly okay with that. Because it's not that I don't mind playing it on its native format. I'd like to play it in widescreen. Because I can live without high definition. I love widescreen. Okay. Let's be clear about this. Oh, look at all these soul
gems.
Nice,
Chucks. Chucks is a fan of Final Fantasy 2. He said it will always be my personal favorite and the black sheep of the series. I enjoyed 2. 2 was very interesting.
Or
it takes
4?
A bit. 2.
Okay. I just have to ask.
Well, no, technically it would be considered the black sheep, James, because of the battle system.
Well, the battle system was almost like the other ones. The main difference was that everybody had a weapon proficiency.
No, you didn't actually gain standard experience. You leveled up, like, your defense would go up depending on how much damage you sustained during a fight. Things like that. And you could change whichever weapon. So you weren't actually restricted to a specific weapon for each person. Each person could do their own weapon. So I've got Maria fucking monking it up there.
Monking it up.
Yep, she's a monk. As in just, you know, fist.
Fisticuffs. Can't use the...
Yeah, it's sad when my Maria just
Maria!
With fist... No.
Sorry.
With just her fist is out damaging the guys with swords and axes. It's like, assholes.
I had a monk in Disgaea that was doing almost as much damage as Laharl, and she was just using her bare hands. She didn't even have a spiked knuckles or anything like that.
Yeah, my Maria is stronger than Guy.
She was a banff. Right, for the first time in 10 weeks, So that'd be about 30 hours. I could actually walk around without being over encumbered. That is fantastic. Yeah, Word Man, kind of like, what was it, West Side Story was with Maria? Was that West Side Story? Or am I thinking something else?
Final Fantasy VI Opera.
Oh, okay. Oh, Maria. Yeah, exactly. You know, man, it was like back in 06 in Game Informer. That's when I first saw the rumor that they were talking, Square was in talks.
Yeah, the keyword system was closed.
That Square was supposed to be doing a 3D remake of 6. And while I was scared to hell of that notion, because I don't want... It's not that I don't want things to change. I don't want things to get worse in just the pure efforts of just trying to make things better. Don't do it for the sake of doing it, which was my biggest problem with almost every game that came out in the fifth generation of consoles. We have to make everything 3D because now we have the ability to make the 3D, and a lot of games were shit as a result of that.
3D killed the Mana series.
Yeah, it did.
The PS2 Mana game?
Dawn of Mana?
No. Or maybe it was Dawn of Mana.
Hold on, now I'm going to rack my brain until I know.
It was such a bad game.
I remember.
I wanted to
biggest...
like it because it was a Mana game. I'm like, oh, why?
Dawn of Mana. Yep, that's it. This is something about a game for the PS2 that should be a warning to everyone that wants to play it, that one of its best features is Havoc physics. Are you kidding me? It didn't even mention anything about the epic story, which really wasn't all that great. That should be a warning of epic proportions. So, what do I have? I cured my vampirism. I went to the Deepsworn Hollow and got rid of it after I realized there's no real tangible benefit to vampirism.
Legend of Mana, I'll have to stream, because that's still good. That's
yeah,
good
Legend
game.
Of Mana.
In my opinion, Legend of Mana was the last good Mana game. Like, Sword of Mana is just, it's a remake of the original Mana game, with more added to it.
Yeah, which... No, I have it.
Wordman, don't ever mention that game again in my presence.
Oh, gosh. Okay, so, big question. Which is the canon game part of Sword of Mana? Is it the girl, or is it the boy?
It's the guy's storyline.
Okay.
Yep.
Gotcha. Because that was like, I have it, and I bought it when someone traded it in.
Sorry,
because I actually had my copy of Final Fantasy Adventure with me, and we fired it up, and we had the title screen playing, you know, Final Fantasy Through the Ages, Wild Arms on the PS1.
See, I have the PS2 remake of Wild Arms 1.
Wild Arms, altered code F, if I'm remembering correctly.
Yep. Which maybe I'll stream that one day when I get my PS2 up here. Unless it comes out for the PSN before then.
Please have it be flawless.
But
that's
no,
all I ask.
Said Kelly is
Whoa, I'm drowning! Oh,
she plays Legend of Mana. Yeah, James got to witness me playing Legend of Mana. I was yelling at the screen a lot.
Why are you yelling at screen?
Let me just put it this way. The female dragoon Sierra, not gonna lie, at one point when I was fighting her, I did yell, "Bitch, I'ma pull your weave out."
Oh my god. Wow.
I'm not gonna lie.
No reason should you have any reason to lie. Crab battle!
Yeah, it was turn-based, Jax.
Gotta go fast.
Xenogears is good. I have that.
Crabs.
I stole it from my college boyfriend.
He deserved it.
With the shit that I put up with? Hell yes. Besides, that bitch took my official copy of Final Fantasy Tactics. Not the greatest hits, the actual first release.
The Black Border original. What a jerk.
Samuel's video? Huh?
Oh, this guy on YouTube, Samuel to GTA, called out Jared as being a pretentious son of a bitch.
Oh, that's somebody not... link. Hold on a minute. Somebody link me that video. I need to see this now.
Yeah. He doesn't really call him that, but that's what he's.
I would like to see this.
Yeah, because like he pulled up a tweet that Jared said that people that are in denial that YouTube content producers aren't the next big thing are in denial, and he basically says you need to go ahead and get your priorities in check. So I've been having this big long feud with this guy on his channel, leaving well thought out replies to his comments, which are shot full of holes. This guy really can't seem to form an argument.
Okay, I'm putting this on mute while I watch this. Hold on.
Okie dokie. Actually, don't put it on mute. We want to hear your reactions as it happens. Oh, he's a kitty! Big kitty. Big Jonathan, I didn't know you were in this game. Hello, kitty. Kitty. He's a big kitty. Good kitty.
Well, let's see this then. I don't know if the sound's going to bleed through.
If it does, then, you know, just go ahead and...
Oh, God, this is 10 minutes?
Yep. It's around the 807 mark where he blinks.
Oh, okay, good, because I don't feel like watching Dirt Stash here go on.
Oh, yeah. You know, the thing is, he's supposedly been doing this for 5 years. And some
Seriously?
Of these channels do go back to, like, early 2005 when YouTube came out. The production values of his channel have not changed one iota. He's only gotten bigger. It's a dirty Sanchez. For those of you who don't know what a dirty Sanchez is, go look it up on Urban Dictionary. Yes, yes it is, but not as disgusting as Handsome Tom actually using it in one of his top 10 lists, talking about I think it was Balls 3D for the Super Nintendo. Holy crap, I found a place that hasn't been discovered yet. Well then. So peaceful in the forest at night. Oh, another well. Perfect. No, wait, I will beat him to death with my bare hands.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, that guy's a tool, isn't he?
Okay, let's see. First of all, He
All right,
still
here
we go. No. He still looks like he lives in the same room that he has since his mom popped him out of her fucking womb. I mean, the Samuel in the background, oh my god, it looks like something he did when he's fucking 5 years old. And not to mention, he's got a fucking dirt stash. He looks like a fucking rapist. He looks like one of those people that just sits on fucking playground and goes, ha. Oh. Them little children's look ripe and fresh. Like, seriously. And that shirt that he's wearing looks like probably the only thing that might not be stained with shame and Cheetos. And the fact that he's, like, shitting on Jared for what Jared said, I was like, I'm sorry. Is there not pretty much on every brand new fucking phone the YouTube video, like, app?
Yeah.
It's like, fuck. And it's like, my BlackBerry has a YouTube app. Fucking every other phone has a YouTube app, and the fact that he's like, YouTube is not going to be the face of entertainment, and they've been saying it since 2006, really? Because again, YouTube is now pretty much in every single fucking phone. Is there not
a
YouTube?
It's on every major console now.
It's on every major console. You can actually rent movies via YouTube now.
I actually bought the pilot to the Munsters reboot 1313 Mockingbird Lane on YouTube.
Yeah. So, and it's like, I'm sorry, but it's just like, and then he's just like, yeah, people on YouTube aren't going to be famous and blah, 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 blah. And this from a guy who has 200 fucking videos? He's probably just fucking pissed off that he's been trying his damnedest to make videos, but he looks like such a dirty, skeezy little creeper that all he can do is go and shit on other people. So I'm just like, of course he's never going to be popular, and like, the fuck?
Oh, it gets even better, because one of my comments was, this is how vindictive that I can get. My athletics rolled up. He said he has a channel that has 6 million views. And at first, I didn't think that'd be possible. So I went ahead and counted up every video that's on that channel that he posted. His grand total view count came to about 109,000. That's not even 1.7% of Jared's total views on his channel. So I went ahead and dug around a little more and found out he has another channel called The Crass Cast. I guess it's his video podcast. Dug around on that. It has about 200,000. So that's 2.2%. Dug around a little bit more, found his game reviews channel. Earlier in the video, he says game reviews, you know, will never be a survivable medium, and Nintendo had every right to do that, and he's glad that they're doing that, taking away all the revenue from people that are complaining about it. And I'm like, oh, but you think it's okay to go and do reviews, and you don't post it on that channel because you don't want to look like a hypocrite. Well, those videos are averaging about 2,500 to about 5,000 views per week. So maybe a 6 million view claim could be true over a 6-year period. Here's something that he needs to keep in mind. If he has 6 million views and Jared has 11 million views, Jared has one video that has 4.3 million views.
Yeah, the how to make Slender not scary.
Exactly. So to that point, Jared has done 2/3 of what that guy's life work is in one video. Not to mention Jared's videos are averaging in the 50,000s or higher, and many of them in the 100,000s or higher. So, Kelly, if you would like to go ahead and leave a well-thought-out retort to him and, you know, tell him to S-A-D.
Maybe later, because honestly, right now, I'd probably just tell him to shut the fuck, fatty, go get a bra for your bitch tits and shave your fucking dirt stash because you look like a pedo.
Well, I think that would be okay, too. Because you're a girl and you can get away with that.
He doesn't know that. Nor do I really want him clicking on my videos, because then he's probably like, oh, you're one of those fucking bitches that probably just goes and streams and be like, I'm a girl on the internet and I play video games, la la la. Fuck you,
pedo
stash.
I have tits, donate! Boo. Alright, let's get Shadow Me here, because she's probably been
You left
water.
The fucking volume up that loud, James? You're an asshole. I was making food for my mom, and all we could hear was Kelly ranting and calling that dude a rapist. We were laughing
gosh.
So hard. I'm sorry. He does. He looks like a pedophile rapist that just goes and sits there. He
Pony.
Probably drives an ice cream truck.
Hey, ding, 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 ding.
It's like, seriously, he probably drives the fucking ice cream truck up and down the street, because God knows he's not chasing one with how fucking huge he is. Christ. With his bitch tit slapping in the breeze. Fuck.
Yeah, he's got bitch tits like freaking, what's his name? Meatloaf in Fight Club. Hey, Epic, glad to hear that your video's doing that well. Have you checked your analytics to find out where your view source is coming from? What was it, puppy? Oh, look at the puppy. We're going to get a little closer to the puppy. Hold on. Oh, it's a big puppy. It's a timber wolf. It's Alpha Unit. It's John Talbane when he's not in his way. When he's not fighting. Get back on my horse, because my horse is amazing. Shadow Mary's best pony.
Like, frig, I only have 42 subscribers. Jeez.
Yeah, Domino and I are 990 subscribers away from being able to stream on YouTube. Yep, because YouTube said it's open to all partners that have 1,000 subscribers or more. Here's just one thing. For all the shit that we give Twitch about its inconsistencies, at least the app and the email notifications that a channel has gone live actually works. I've never had a notification for YouTube work. Which means you basically have to be logged into that channel to know when they're going live. That's not going to work. That needs to change if that is supposed to be a viable income revenue stream. So, actually, you know, on that note, since we are right outside Manea's Razor, the entrance for Manea's Razor, that is, I think this would be a good place to stop for tonight. And I guess we'll pick up sometime soonish with Manea's Razor, and once we finish that, I think that will be all that's left for the main game. Yeah, all that's left is that. Close an Oblivion Gate. Locate the Dagon Shrine. Deliver the Daedric Artifact. Destroy the gate. Complete main quest line. Yeah, that's all that's left, because the only thing I did was escape from the sewers. Otherwise, we would still be here, so... Oh, man. Good times. And thank you all for the ones that came out for the one-year anniversary stream. That was so very awesome. And how Kelly went ahead and took a little nappy poo and the viewership went up by the time I got back. That was still like, pretty funny.
Pretty much.
Yep. So, that being said...
And sorry, Beryl, I normally don't insult people that are bigger, but I'm sorry, when you're a pretentious asshole dick like that, that's when I will insult you.
Oh, yeah.
Still looks like a fucking pedophile rapist, though.
He looks pretty damn crazy. Creepy, and all the other wild people that I would not want to associate with. Oh, man, the Oblivion game from the PSP that died 8 million years ago? Wait, is there something that was... Yeah. Lack of free roaming. It'll feature 10 large levels. Influenced by Metroid Prime. Yeah, that would have been interesting. If it had that transfaring that we see in Metal Gear Portable Ops, that would have been interesting. But it never came to be. So, yeah, Oklahoma's getting its ass knocked around about like this time last year. You guys might remember that Screwing Around got canceled.
Mm-hmm.
And because those tractor trailers are getting thrown all over the place around Texas, then we all watched Jared play Zelda, and then he bumped the NES.
There it is. Best stream ever.
Oh, man. That was brutal.
We're just like, they even ScrewTech's like, well, we're not in the office, but Jared's streaming. Here, go watch him.
Yeah. Go watch him. Have fun.
Go watch Jared play.
Yeah, for real. Let's watch Jared play Awesome Sauce. So, good night, Red Punk.
I miss him playing RPGs and like old RPGs. I'm like, aww.
Yeah. I don't see how that wouldn't be a good thing for his channel. More so, not, you know, not be a good thing for his YouTube channel, which is something that I pinged him about months and months ago. Said, why aren't you putting your archives on your YouTube channel? You know, your fans would love to watch that. You know, glad he is now. He's doing the Nuzlocke stuff. Unfortunately, I think he got nailed for that, so it is what it is. Hopefully, Nintendo of America was paying attention to what Cliff Bleszinski was tweeting over the weekend, saying, if you're that guy that's going to go ahead and hound your fans for ad revenue, you're no better than the guy who's at a convention that's charging for autographs. By the way, if you're charging for autographs at a convention, that means you're pretty much at the end of your career.
You do know why celebrities charge for autographed photos, right?
Normally they're compensated for their appearance at conventions.
No, actually they're not. They're really not. Unless they are like the guest of honor. Yeah, let's say, unless they're actually the guest of honor, and the only reason I know this is because two of my sister's friends, they work pretty much like all the convention circuits, so they actually upright said, because I was making this complaint going, I can't believe that, you know, they won't let us take photos of, you know, ex-celebrity or whatever, and they're like, that's how they get their money, because they're invited up, and again, depending on what level ranking they are, so either if the guest of honor or, you know, the... not exactly guest of honor, but hey, look, we have this person. Their hotel might be paid for, but and that they're not paid for the X amount of hours that they're sitting on the floor. They're not paid for their meals or anything. It's just their hotel. It's paid for.
That's not normally what I hear, because that's when people were saying that can't we get some X, Y, and Z at SGC, and the response back, no way, that guy's appearance fee is way too big. So
yeah,
maybe
no,
it
it's just
from person to
that's,
person.
Like that's
I know Tara
like...
Strong says she'd rather get the her appearance fee donated to her favorite charity instead.
Yeah,
you know,
but she's probably brought
paid.
In as like a big guest though. That's probably why.
Oh well, you know, the most of her stuff is either at Comic-Con because of her voice acting work, or at BronyCon, or any of those other Brony things because of her involvement with MLP. But long and short of it. Wait, how did we get on this subject anyway? I totally lost my mind. Yeah, the partnership program used to be a special thing. I think when YouTube realized how much money that they were leaving out by not opening it up to people that met the criteria, that's probably where they're doing it. Because they were, what is it, $1.8 billion a year is how much they're generating in ad revenue now from the last time I heard. Dude, I don't even have... Oh, you have 1,000 subs, 100 views, still partner. Yeah. Yeah, things do tend to spiral out of control. Yes, I do know Google's behind YouTube. Yes, I know. I'm not oblivious to that. They bought them, and I remember a lot of people saying, that's the dumbest thing. They're going to lose all the money in the world. Well, that didn't happen, did it? Idiots. Anyways, speaking of partners, hey, James, why don't you go ahead and plug your Onnit video while you're in here? Because that seems to be going viral right now, and I wouldn't mind that catching the world on fire. So anyway, news. Right, Victoria, G1 Hyper Combo 64, Super Street Fighter 4 tomorrow afternoon, Kanan doing Alice tomorrow evening.
Or Dark Souls, depending.
Or Dark Souls, depending on who's available. I think I will probably get around to doing Fatal Frame on Friday, if you're off. I think, maybe.
I don't know. I'll double check.
Okay. And then, oh, yeah, that's right. The Xbox announcement stream tomorrow. I will go ahead and start it at 12:45 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, and then run it for 15 minutes, a half an hour afterwards, just to see what you guys think about everything. I know everybody else is doing their own thing, too. I figured, why the hell not? So, Oh, the counter's still frozen, James? That's a good sign. That's a very, very good sign. So, yes, everybody, if you like Earthbound, or if you just like music, go ahead and click the link that James, a.k.a. Epic Game Music, just dropped in the chat. So, anyways, that will do it for me tonight. Thank you so much for being a part of the great event that was saving the Shivering Isles from Jiggalag. And that was actually cool. We did it. We did it from start to finish. Everything in the Shivering Isles has been done. So all that left is Medea's Razor and the main quest. And goodness knows how long that's going to take. But
and on a side note, it's been 10 years since Buffy ended.
Oh, boy.
You gonna cry now?
Wow. Where has the time gone? So, sounded like Bentley there for a second. Pours a 40 on the sidebar till we meet at the crossroads again. So, well, anyway, that'll do it. Good night, everybody. And we will get the archive of the tubes of you in the not-too-distant future.
Hi, people.
I'm having an old moment. Every day is an old moment for me. All right. Anyway, night-night, peoples.
And I get to hug the one that played Anya.